Hello again. In this video, I'm going to help you with something that a lot of people have been asking me for help with, and that is how to share your audio or video in a Zoom meeting. This is very useful if you have a video that you want to talk about your students with, or maybe even some audio for a listening test, something like that. This is a really useful feature, and you need to watch this carefully because there's a few little things that you need to do just to make sure that everything is correct. So without further ado, let's get into it, shall we? I'm going to move over to Zoom now, just to warn you that the camera is going to go a little bit crazy because I have many, many applications right now, open right now. I can feel that my computer is getting a bit hotter. But anyway, let's go to Zoom. And as I said, here's the other camera, it's a little bit crazy. Don't worry about that. But the important thing is, how do you share a video or audio in Zoom? So we are in the Zoom meeting right now. Again, I don't have anybody to talk to, it's just me, but let's pretend there's somebody there. What you want to do is click on Share Screen, just as we did with the whiteboard before. And you can see all of these different options here. These are all of the different applications that I have open on my computer. So you can share a web page on your internet browser. You can share a video, you can share audio. Of course, you can share the whiteboard as well. But in this case, we want to share a video, right? So there's a few ways you can do this. You can do this on YouTube. You could do this with a video file that you have on your computer. Now, whichever one you share, this is very, very, very important. At the bottom here, you have this little checkbox. Can you see that? Share computer sound. So you want to make sure that you click that. You can also have this optimized screen share for video clip. You can click that as well. I don't think that one is super important. Maybe it makes the video look a little bit nicer, but the really important one is this, share computer sound. The reason you want to click on this is because if you click this, then the other person will hear exactly what is coming out of your computer. However, if you don't click on this, then the other person will just hear what's coming from your microphone. So let's say you're watching a video, for example, they're gonna hear the audio recorded from your microphone from the video, which is not gonna sound so good. So share computer sound, you wanna click that. And let's say, for example, you have a file, a video file on your computer. I've got one here, so on QuickTime Player, you click on that, then you click on share. All right, and here is the video. It's a video of me, this is inside of our community. We have a guest teacher here, Emily from America, we're just having a chat. So if I want to show this video.
So this means someone who...
Okay, the video might be a bit shaky because, as I said, my computer is recording the screen. But anyway, you can do that, you can share the video, and it's great. So once you've finished, of course, you can just move backwards and forwards as you would normally with a video. And then once you are finished, I'm not sure if you can see this on the screen here, maybe not. But there is a button at the top which says stop share. I don't think you can see that on this recording, unfortunately, but just look for that button. It's a big red one, well, not that big, but red. Click on stop share. And then you will come back. So you want to come, you can come back to your main discussion with the person. Oh, that was an interesting video. What do you think about that? And then maybe you want to share another video, but this one is on YouTube. So let's click again on screen share. And then we'll click on, I've got Firefox here. I've got a YouTube video prepared. This is BBC News. And again, I can just click on play. So there we go. That is the video you could share on YouTube. You could click on the button to make it bigger. And yeah, that's gonna work pretty nicely. So you could share a video on YouTube or a file on your computer. And then again, once you have finished, you click on Stop Share. Again, I don't think you could see that on the screen, unfortunately. Stop Share, and then you come back. Then you're done. And the last thing I want to show you is how to share just audio. Maybe you don't want to share a video, but you just want to share the audio. Maybe it's music, maybe it is a listening exercise. Probably that, right? So in this case, you want to keep the video, the video chat like it is now. You don't want to show anything, just the audio. So what you want to do this time, again, click on Screen Share, and you want to click on Advanced. Okay, so now you've got Basic, Advanced, and Files. You want to click on Advanced, and then we're going to click on Computer Sound Only. Computer Sound Only. And then you click on Share. Now, now we are back in the video call again. Now, anything that I play on my computer, the other person will hear clearly. Okay? So let's say, for example, I'm going to go onto iTunes here. Okay? Now, the other person won't see this. The student won't see this. This is what you will see, the student won't see this. So I'm going to go into iTunes and just play some music. Move it up and down. So we are in the chat. And they can hear what's coming out of my computer. That's pretty cool, right? And again, if I can just stop that music, and then when you don't need to share the audio anymore, again, you will just click at the top, you can see it this time, click on Stop Share, okay? And it will stop sharing the audio from your computer. So yeah, that is about it. You can do this, all of the steps that I just showed you, you can do for sharing your desktop, but if you share your, why don't we just do that now? If you share your screen, then you don't need to have this on, share computer sound, right? You don't need that on. If you just want to share, let's say, your screen, I want to go onto BBC News, or you want to check something online, you want to show your students at the same time, then then you can do that, okay? And then once you have finished, again, you want to click on Stop Share, and you will come back. So I hope that makes sense. It's a little bit difficult to show all of this in a video while I'm recording the screen, but hopefully you've got the main idea. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Let me know if this was useful. Let me know if there are some other things that you want me to help you with. I'll probably make a video about breakout rooms as well sometime soon. So yeah, let me just come back to the better camera here. All right, so I hope that was useful. Yeah, practice that. Just remember, you have to, the small little things you have to do, make sure the computer sound is checked, that little button there. And yeah, have fun on Zoom, sharing video and audio with your students, and I hope everybody's online teaching is going very well so far. Bye-bye.